Naviom AIS is the newest AIS transceiver powered by SOTDMA technology. The use of modern components made it possible to create a unique product in the market. The average power consumption was reduced to 1 watt, which is 3 times less than most other transceivers. High CPU performance and Wi-Fi support made it possible to create a device with newest features that wasn't available in the market. The mobile application allowed the use AIS even without a chart plotter. In this video, we will look at the Naviom AIS web interface and the opportunities that a mobile application gives. To connect to the Naviom AIS web interface, you must either find the Naviom AIS device in the folder network in your computer or enter http://naviomais.local in the address bar of the web browser. Before connecting, make sure to connect Naviom AIS to the power supply and to be in the same Wi-Fi network as Naviom AIS. Upon initial setup, it is a Wi-Fi network named Naviom. Through the Device Management menu, you can open the following sections: Vessels, Friendly Ships, Device Status, Device Configuration. To display the data received by Naviom AIS, we need to go to the Vessel section. Here we see several filters that allow to display only the data we are interested in: a filter by time, a filter by distance, approaching ships, aids to navigation with information from navigation bias, meteo and hydrographic data from meteo stations, records containing additional information, text messages, the farthest ships from the moment the device was turned on. If we enter 0 in the time filter, Naviom AIS will display all saved data. Please note that this video provides testing data with emulation of ship traffic to demonstrate the capabilities of Naviom AIS. So let's consider what information Naviom AIS can to us. In the section on ship information, data is displayed in the form of blocks with information about the ships. If we follow the link at the top of the block, we will get to the ship's card with all available data. The card is automatically updated every 15 seconds. To disable this function, uncheck the box Auto Update. Also at the bottom there is a button for adding a vessel to the list of friendly ships. The ship's information section contains the identification data of the ship, its dimensions, location, speed, course, data on the distance of the ship at the current moment, and the direction. The direction is given in a clock position relative to the course of your ship. 1 hour corresponds to 30 degrees, thus the circle is divided into 12 hours. The ship that we consider is located on our port side at the distance of 2.7 nautical miles. Information is also provided on the point of intersection and the point of least distance. In the block of information about the point of intersection, in addition to data on the time when this point will be reached and at what distance the ships will be from each other, you can find also information on the sequence of passage of this point and the time range for the vessel of our interest in this point. In our example, when the ships maintain their current course and speed, we will first read the intersection point in 6 minutes and 8 seconds. The distance to the ship at this point will be 1,696 meters and it will be the 8 hours relative to the course of our ship. Then we will have the point of intersection of closest point of approach, which will occur in 8 minutes and 36 seconds from the current moment. The distance between the ships will be 951 meters and the ship can be observed for 6 hours relative to the course of our ship, after which the ships will begin to move away from each other. Then, another ship will approach the point of intersection, and it will happen in 9 minutes and 2 seconds relative to the current moment. If for some reason new data on the location of the ship of our interest will be not received, after updating the ship's card, Naviom AIS will simulate the movement of the ship using the latest data on its location, course, and speed. This allows to more accurately provide information about the current distance between the ships and the time when the point of intersection of the courses and the point of smallest distance are reached. At the end of the block is statistical information. If only part of the information about the vessel is displayed, this means that the vessel either doesn't transmit other data such as its location or course, or these data haven't yet been received, because statistic information containing the name of the vessel, its call sign, dimensions, and transmitted separately from the location, course, and speed of the vessel. If the vessel transmits additional information, a corresponding field will appear with relevant information. Upon receipt of meteorological and hydrographic data, you can also see them in the additional information field. Here are examples of messages containing text. If the messages are confidential, they will be encrypted and will not be displayed. Text messages can also be viewed in the corresponding section. To edit the list of friendly ships or add a new one, open the Friendly Ships section. Here you can see a list of existing records with friendly ships and the form for adding new ones. You can use either Latin or any other national symbols for the name of the vessel. The maximum length for this field is 200 characters. In addition to the name, the MMSI number of the vessel also must be indicated. And if you want to receive notifications in the mobile application about the appearance of the vessel in sight, check the corresponding box, then save the record. After creating a record, a vessel with the MMSI number will be displayed with the name that you assigned to it. In this case, the true name of the vessel can be seen in the box below. For the convenience of finding the necessary record, you can sort the list of friendly ships by name, MMSI number or data of entry. In order to disable notifications in the mobile application, uncheck the Notify box. To delete the entry, click the Delete button. In the Device Configuration section, we can set the static information about the vessel transmitted via AIS communication channels, particularly the name of the vessel, its MMSI number, call sign, dimensions of the vessel, its type, and operation mode of the radio transmitter. There are two ways to indicate the size of a vessel. The first way is to explicitly set the length and width of the vessel in meters. In the second method, we specify the location of the GPS receiver on the ship, in our case, Naviom AIS. For this, we use a sign plus. In this case, we indicated that the GPS receiver on our vessel is 15 meters from the bow of a vessel, 5 meters from the stern, 4 meters from the port side, and 1 meter from the starboard side, while the total dimensions of the vessel will be 20 meters in length and 5 meters wide. Also, in the device configuration section, we can make changes to the settings related to the operation of the mobile application. Change the bus speed NMEA0183. Set up a Wi-Fi network connection. Change the password for the device. Update Naviom AIS software. The device status section contains the following information: status of the main components of the device, AIS configuration, GPS module status, radio module status, NMEA2000 bus statistics, Wi-Fi module status. By radio modules, you can also display statistics on the types of messages received. On the NMEA2000 bus, you can see a list of devices running on the bus. We showed you the main features of the Naviom AIS web interface. Now let's explore the capabilities of the mobile application. To install the Naviom AIS mobile application, go to the Google Play Market and find the Naviom AIS app. Then install it. Let's look at the application menu. In the upper right corner, you see three buttons. Button for the device's web interface, the button for centering the map on your own ship, and the menu button. There are items in the menu: exit the menu, maps, notification settings, enter the password for the device, switch to the simplified display mode of ships, and the button to exit the program. In the map section, you can select the map that will be used by the application. If the desired map is missing, then you can download it. For this, click the Add button, select the region and country of interest, then click the Download button. Be careful when loading large maps. Estimate in advance the free space on your mobile device and the cost of this amount of data, taking into account the tariff of your service provider. Let's see what information is displayed on the map. Here you can see lateral and cardinal bias. Anchorage sites, marinas and their names, navigation lights, lighthouses, and much more. And of course, we will be interested in information about our own location and the location of other vessels. There are three colors that display ships. Green is always your ship. Red are ships that are dangerous, those with a distance to our ship at the smallest distance less than the value that we set in the Naviom AIS settings. Blue, all other ships. A course line departs from the ship at the true course of the ship. If information about the ship's position, heading, is transmitted, the ship's icon will be oriented in the direction. The length of the course line depends on the speed of the ship and can tell us what point the ship will be after a certain period of time. Information about this is given at the bottom of the screen. But this only applies to the blue course line. For ships with a speed of more than 20 knots, the course line is drawn in red and its length always corresponds to a speed of 20 knots. If we click on the ship that interests us, the ship card will open with detailed information. We received the content of this card earlier. In the upper left corner, you can see the current speed and course of your ship. The map scale is displayed in the lower left corner. Concentric circles diverge around the image of your ship. The distance between the circles corresponds to the scale and allows you to quickly assess the distance to objects on the map. If you prefer a simplified view of the display of ships, you can switch to it through the menu. In case of one of the events that are configured on the settings section of the mobile application, a notification will be displayed on the mobile device with information about this event. When you click on the button, you will receive additional information related to this event. These are the main features of the Naviom AIS mobile app. Thank you for your interest in the Naviom AIS transceiver. We hope this video was useful for you. If you have questions, you can always ask them using the feedback form on our webpage naviom.com.